The design of this fence is also like heritage. It's still there from many years. So that's where it differentiates between the Boca, which is the heritage part of Cape Town, and that's where the modern part of Cape Town starts. Hello friends, welcome to my channel Roaming Devi. Today I am at a place which is very very important in terms of the heritage importance of South Africa. This place is called Bokap. You can see there are a lot of colorful houses behind me which is having its own importance. I'll explain you going forward. And this is worldwide people visit here to see the heritage part of Cape Town, and this is mostly nearby city center actually. So it's like 20 minutes of walk or 25 minutes of walk from the waterfront, which is one of the most tourist place actually people visit there. And it is also 5-10 minutes of walk from the center of the city actually. And this community is just on the foothill of Signal Hill. There's one mountain, and also you can see the Table Mountain also. And most of the people who travel Cape Town, they must visit this place because it has a heritage relationship, and it has a good understanding how South Africa became a diversified culture, and it all started from here actually. So let's see, and I'll explain you what is this colorful houses, why it is colorful, bright color. There are many houses here. Let's go to the lanes of this narrow lanes of heritage area, and I'll show you. The place name is called Bokap, BOKAAP. Okay, लेट्स गो. तो ये जो जगह है ये मिडिल ऑफ है. यू कैन सी राइट हैंड साइड इज द मेन मॉडर्न सिटी ऑफ केप टाउन, और मेरे जो लेफ्ट साइड में है यू कैन सी द हेरिटेज पार्ट ऑफ केप टाउन. सो देर इज अ क्लियर डिस्टिंक्शन अबाउट द मॉडर्न एंड द हेरिटेज पार्ट एक्चुअली. वंस यू वॉक डाउन टू दिस वॉल स्ट्रीट द हेरिटेज रूट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम हियर. देन फ्रॉम हियर द ऑल द कलरफुल हाउसेज ऑफ Bokap, द ब्यूटिफुल हाउसेज ऑफ Bokap स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम हियर. So let's move. You can see how vibrant the colors are. You can see that's a different color, that's also a different color, that's a different color, and then you can see here another different color. So that's the beauty of this place. You can see all these houses, the roof is flat. Unlike in Cape Town, where it is kind of European kind of style houses are there in Cape Town, but if you see this historical house, this all houses roof is almost flat, and it remain as it is from 100 to 200 years old houses actually. अब मैं इसके कुछ हेरिटेज हिस्ट्री के बारे में बताता हूँ. अब दिस प्लेस Bokap, यहाँ पे जब 1700 टाइम में स्लेव्स फ्रॉम वेरियस कंट्रीज लाइक इंडोनेशिया, मलेशिया, इंडिया, इवन वेस्ट ऑफ अफ्रीका, उन लोगों को सब इधर लाया गया, एंड दे आर गिवेन एज अ रेंट इन दिस हाउसेस. ये द हाउसेस, यहाँ पे इनके लिए घर बनाया गया, तो वो लोग हाउसेस में रेंट दिया गया था, और वो कलर्स ऑफ वाइट ही था एक्चुअली. ओके, सो they continued with their mixed culture actually. So with that mixed culture, this community grows up, and now it is still present. And that's where we call it, I mean the African people they call it as a Cape Malaya Quarter actually. और यहीं से बहुत सारा चीज़ का मतलब हेरिटेज वाइज का इम्पोर्टेंस बढ़ गया. तो बेसिकली यहाँ पे जो कलरफुल हाउस का जो इम्पोर्टेंस है मैं वो बोलने जा रहा हूँ. व्हाट हैपेंड जब वो जो रूल्स था जहाँ पे कि रेसिज्म की वजह से देर आर वेरियस लॉज वेयर देयर वेयर वेयर द स्लेव्स आर नॉट अलाउड टू बाई हाउस. सो दैट टाइम ये लोग वाइट में रहते थे बट इवेंचुअली द लॉज को उन्होंने चेंज किया एंड द स्लेव्स आर अलाउड टू बाई प्रॉपर्टीज. So as the owners who sell them those houses to those slaves as a mark of a freedom actually they painted these their houses with a bright color actually. और जो slave जिन लोगों को जो घर मिला था जो लोग उन्होंने property खरीदा था उस time का जो color है it is still maintained here. That's the reason various colors are maintained, bright colors are maintained for each of the house and सब घर का अपना अपना एक importance भी है. जैसे कि मान लीजिए एक doctor है and how he wanted to identify that he's a doctor, वो अपना दरवाज़ा को एक स्पेशल कलर डाल के रखता था. सो नाउ डूइंग आई मीन ईयर्स ईयर फिर उन्होंने उस डोर को चेंज करके फिर घर को किया, फिर घर को करने के बाद फिर वॉल को किया. सो दैट बिकेम इंडियन नेम. अच्छा वो ब्लू कलर वाला जो घर है वो डॉक्टर का है या वो ग्रीन कलर वाला जो घर है वो है जो मलय कुजिन जो फूड आइटम्स होते हैं वो बनाने में एक्सपर्ट है. सो इवन स्टिल ऑल्सो इट एग्जिस्ट. यहाँ पर जो पॉपुलेशन है सब लोग सबको जानते हैं. दे आर वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर एंड इट इज़ वेरी डिस्टिंक्टिव फ्रॉम द मॉडर्न लाइफ ऑफ केप टाउन एंड इट इज़ मोस्टली डोमिनेटेड बाई मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी. और यहाँ पे बहुत सारे मतलब बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मिक्स कल्चर मतलब इंडिया से आए हैं इंडोनेशिया से आए हैं सब लोग अपना फूड का वेराइटीज़ लाए तो दे मिक्सड अप एंड दे क्रिएट लॉट ऑफ मलय क्विज़िन एक्चुअली. यहाँ पे करी वगैरह बनती है, यहाँ पे स्पेशल आइटम्स भी जैसे समोसा है, मीट करी है एंड देर आर वेरी स्पेसिफिक फूड आइटम्स विच यूल गेट विथ इज ऑथेंटिक एंड यूल गेट इट इन दिस प्लेस एक्चुअली. जो कि इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर मी इन दिस कोविड सिचुएशन टू कवर दोज प्लेस. सो दिस इज़ द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस हेरिटेज साइट. सो मैं ये रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ कोई भी अगर केपटाउन घूमने आता है, फाइन केपटाउन इज़ अ ब्यूटिफुल सिटी, सीनिक्स, लॉट ऑफ मॉडर्न जगह है, काफ़ी जगह घूमने के लिए. डोंट मिस दिस प्लेस ऑल्सो. इट हैज़ अ वेरी बिग रिलेशनशिप इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट्स हेरिटेज एंड देर आर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स अराउंड दिस प्लेस एक्चुअली. यहाँ पे जो मस्क है, आई एम गोइंग टू वॉक देयर एंड शो यू दैट मस्क इज द फर्स्ट मस्क इन साउथ अफ्रीका. 1960 ऐसा कुछ टाइम पीरियड बना था. टेल यू द स्पेसिफिक्स वंस आई रीच देयर. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द हेरिटेज इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ दैट मस्क हियर. सो लेट्स गो. ये देखिए मेरे पीछे जो ये जो चीज़ है द डिज़ाइन विच यू कैन सी यू कैन फाइंड इन इंडिया ऑल्सो. मोस्ट ऑफ द हाउसेज हैविंग दिस काइंड ऑफ डिज़ाइन ऑन देयर फेंस आई मीन ऑन द बैल्कोनी एंड ऑल. इवन माई हाउस इज ऑल्सो हैविंग दिस काइंड ऑफ डिज़ाइन एक्चुअली. सो यू कैन सी यहाँ से कितना मिक्सअप है विथ मिक्सड कल्चर बिकॉज ऑफ द पीपल फ्रॉम वेरियस कंट्री दे केम. और यहाँ पर ये डिफिक्ट करता है कि हाउ कल्चर वाइज इट मिक्सड एंड इट शो ऑफ द हिस्ट्री ऑफ दिस प्लेस एक्चुअली. यू कैन सी द हेरिटेज ग्लिम्स ऑफ दिस प्लेस. द डोर कलर इट हैज इज इम्पोर्टेंस. यू कैन सी दिस. इट हैज इज ओन मीनिंग. I mean the door handle also you can see it is having a heritage look.
Hello friends, he is Tariq. He is from Boca Peria and states in Wall Street. And he has a lot of knowledge. He is an authentic person from here. So he is going to help me the glimpse of this area and he is going to give me some insight of this area in some high level way actually. Thank you Tariq for giving me time. Please go ahead. Stage is yours.
My name is Tariq. Okay, so look, it's a very tight knit community. We are the In my opinion, we are probably one of the youngest cultures, and you would say one of the youngest civilizations in the world. You know, one of the last places that was formed by colonialism, last places that was formed to create a new identity. And Cape Town is a true metropolitan area with diversity. colors, races, and we have to transcend that. Here in Cape Town, we would like to, you know, certain individuals that invest in a currency called energy, not just money or time and so forth. We want to invest into creating international citizens, you know, and that is what we're trying to fight and preserve is already there. We're not even 100% understanding our fights in this regard, but yeah, we see beauty in the smallest things, and we appreciate family, we appreciate our community, and we are a country that born out of struggle, you know, and we know hardship, and we also know how to enjoy ourselves. So welcome. I'm a street food chef. I do something for my community on...
Is it Malaya food you prepare? The Malaya food or what kind
you
of...
You see, this is something that we want to transcend. Okay. My heritage is Malay food.
Okay.
Right enough, but I would prefer to call it Cape Town food.
Cape Town food. Okay, yeah. Okay. That's great, Tariq. And how you feel about India? It's also very diversified, very heritage.
To be honest, I think that India is, in its own way, probably one of the best places in the world, in its own way.
Yeah,
like a lot of other places in the world, but India, hands above knees, in its own way, it cannot compare to anywhere else.
Thank you very much, Tariq. So you can hear they also love India, and even being in South Africa, I also found there's a lot of similarity in the houses, the designs also somewhat. I just explained the wall also belongs to in my households having the same design. So you can see the similarity between the cultural heritage in this year, where Tariq is also having a good admire of our country, and he's also explaining a very good
my business, my street food business's name, the actual name is called Akani.
Okay.
Which is Indian name.
Okay.
On the south it means to cook into the broth.
Cooking the broth, okay.
Yeah, so Akani is from India.
Okay.
And but so we created it now in South Africa. We recreated it so that it's now something that is not close even to Indian dish.
Indian. No, and I've tested the curries here. The ingredients are almost same, like your garlic and ginger, all those.
Yes,
see,
yes.
In India also.
The Holy Trinity.
Yeah, but in India also you'll find various curries that it's very different, very diversified.
Yes.
Even I have not tested everything, believe
yes.
me. So, but somewhat the curries is matched because the spices are almost same. So, I hope he's going to share me my Instagram. Guys who are coming to Vocab, follow his Instagram for good Malaya Cape food or Cape Town foods, which is authentic. You can follow this guy. I'm going to share all the details in my YouTube description. Please go and meet this guy. He's going to help you.
Show them how lovely our place.
Yeah, let me show your house.
Today you're welcome to Buka, Cape Town. Very kind of food area. Representation and a how culture was formed in Buka. This over here is a depiction of a teacher that came down, one of the first settlers. I know there's a lot of talk about slavery in South Africa and so forth. This man right here was not a slave. He was a political exile. He was an advisor to a king, and he was a wealthy nobleman. Around him you can see might have been slaves, might have been free people, women and men, that he was teaching literature. Rightly enough, the literature that we got was from his heritage, was based around Islamic history and teachings. If you look at the first picture here, you can see this would be a depiction of a black female.
Okay.
Then the next picture might have been taking on the head here, would be Indonesian. As you can see here, the young boy looks African. And as we go forth, you can see Chinese, mixed with Arabian, and Malaysian. There might have been white people, and he's also black people. So it's a diverse culture and history that has no boundaries of race or religion. There's a few other pictures that depicts the trades that were in South Africa. As you can see, we had the cobblers. I'm not too clued up in terms of who this is in particular. That in particular, that one is a special picture, that is Tuang Guru. So he has a very prominent history in Cape Town. This is the horses and carts that we did use, so our ancestors used. That over there was the first mosque.
Where is that mosque?
The mosque is in Dove Street.
You can walk down?
You can go down there.
Is this the way or?
You go up here and then that road.
That is all way right?
Oval.
Yes. Yeah. Also is a representation of a marriage. In this particular instance, this is a white female wearing an Asian Chinese descent.
And these all they settled here actually, that's where the heritage starts. Okay, that's where the diversification all started.
Yes.
From here. Okay,
yes.
Okay, I understand.
There's a large majority of our history is made up with Indonesian, Indian is very much prominent. North Africa, large majority of people from North Africa, Malaysia and Indonesia.
So Tariq has explained me a very nice, he's a very nice gentleman and he given me good insight ki log kaise khana banate, how their culture is so important, and they given me really a good insight. He advised me to walk down on this area where I'll go to the oldest street where I'll find the first mosque of this South Africa actually. So let me see, I'm walking into that street. You can see this Save Our Heritage. The oldest mosque of South Africa, Owl Masjid. It is established in 1794. This mosque was established through an endowment of a freed slave woman named Sarjiban Dikav. So from there, this is the history I have heard from about this mosque actually. So this is the oldest mosque in South Africa. She is Farwa, one of the resident here. I'm very lucky that she given her helping hand to know about the details about this place. She's going to explain me about the mosque which I shown you. Yeah, Farwa, welcome to my channel.
Okay.
Romin Devi.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Okay. So we have 11 mosques in Boka. Mm. And this is the oldest one. It was established in 1794. And we have a lot of people coming here to make prayer every day.
Farwa, I heard this is the oldest mosque in South Africa. That's what I read.
Yes.
In the internet.
Yes, it is. It was established in 1794.
Okay.
So it's quite old.
Quite old.
Yeah.
Okay.